Greetings, everybody, and welcome to the Daily Dance Break. We are going live every day at 11:45 a.m. Eastern Standard. You can join us on Zoom. You can join us on the Instagram story. I am Lissa Mahalik of somaticanatomy.com. This is my lovely assistant, Napoleon Bony Parts. He's trying to brighten up the day because it is gray, gloomy, and gross today here in New York, Bleeping City. So when we are talking about somatics, now, somatics is essentially, it's a mindset, it's a way of looking at things that recognizes no difference between the mind and the body. So what it does is it makes the mind-body connection explicit and conscious, brings it into the forefront of our awareness. In somatics, I like to say all metaphors are real. You do need to get your feet securely on the ground. You do need to reach your head up to the heavens. You do need to feel the protection and openness around your heart. As you keep watching these, and we're on replay in my Facebook group, on my Instagram TV, on my YouTube channel, it's everywhere. You can find this all over the place. Also, if you are on the mailing list, you will get each day's replays showing up in your inbox every day. So if you don't feel like, oh gosh, where did she find this? Oh, cool. I've got that replay in my inbox. Yeah. So you don't miss a thing no matter what time zone you're on or what the heck is going on at 11:45 Eastern Standard for you. Right. So the other thing about somatics is your experience in your body is paramount. Whether or not you're feeling the same things that I'm talking about, it doesn't matter. What you are experiencing in your body is the baseline, and nobody can take that away from you. Keep that in mind at all times. That is one of the true values of somatics. When was the last time someone said, no, that your experience is true and real? Take that in. So, enough about somatics, on to the dancing. Each day, we do a couple of moves that are designed, again, to bring that mind-body connection from implicit and unconscious into explicit and conscious, which means that the fun we have dancing and shaking our booty is going to go all out to the rest of the day. So we're going to really ground this stuff in our bodies. It's going to be awesome, and we're going to have a really freaking good time. Oh, and also, I don't care how good or bad a dancer you are. Trust me on this. Will you see me starting to move? Okay, so today we are getting towards the end of our chakra series. Today we are going with the third eye chakra. Bam, right here. Now this is an interesting one. The third eye is all about I imagine. So pause for a moment and imagine the brave new world that's going to happen when we are all out of our rooms, of our apartments, of our houses, and we can go out and reconnect to each other. How are things going to be different? Because things are going to be different. And how can we make those changes positive and beneficial and more connected than they were before? Let's really value our physical connectedness, the ability to look at somebody in the eye and smile at them without a mask in the way, the ability to give somebody a hug, to shake a hand, to touch somebody on the shoulder who you don't live with. These are valuable things, and imagine how good that's going to feel once we have a chance to do that again. Now, when we're talking about the physical structures of the third eye, we're talking about, specifically, I am talking about the pineal gland. There are lots of different schools of thought about which glands connect with which chakras. In my personal explorations, I have always found the pineal gland to be the strongest link to the third eye chakra, primarily because, anatomy nerd, yo, the pineal gland has actual, whoa, I'm so busy imagining I've forgotten what I'm talking about. The pineal gland has actual light sensing cells in it, and the pineal gland is what's responsible for releasing melatonin into our brains and telling us when the heck it's time to get to sleep and stay asleep. So that is super important. Those light sensing cells really give it a connection with the eyes. They're similar to the light sensing cells we have in our actual eyes. So that's what we're going for today. We're going for the pineal gland. Now, one of the things with the pineal gland is when we are really dropped into our third eye, we are out of that fight or flight reflex and we're deep into the parasympathetic nervous system, the rest and digest reflex. And there are a couple of ways we can contact that. First, we're going to contact it directly through the pineal gland. And you're just going to imagine, inhale through the nose, imagine the breath coming up towards the back of your head right here. And exhale, inhaling. And back, inhaling up. And back, inhaling up and back. And out. And feel how your energy is already changing. We can then move down to directly contacting the parasympathetic nervous system. Make a little arch with your hands. Press it here against the base of your rib cage in front. And as you inhale, flatten it down. As you exhale, let it rise. You are literally following the movement of your diaphragm, your respiratory diaphragm, as you do this. And now, just for balance, because if you open up just one chakra and you leave the rest of the system untouched, the chakras are also where the crazy lives. The chakras are what connect us to other people. They're what connect us to the universe. They're what connect us to something greater than ourselves. But if you open up just one and leave the rest of them unlit, you are going to let a heck of a lot of crazy ass energy out because it will be imbalanced. So to balance, we come from the top. Looking through the center. And then we're going to breathe all the way down into your sacrum and tailbone, inhaling. So you feel it zigzag. Expanding. Contacting that parasympathetic nervous system, that rest and digest, that system starts to kick on when the melatonin flows, and balancing the entire system with that zigzag breathing. And finally, you can just breathe and just feel your entire skull expanding like an egg. You can close your eyes if that helps. You can put your fingers to your temples and just inhale and exhale. And inhale, and exhale. And as you feel your system dropping down into the parasympathetic, we're gonna start moving with that breath, with that awareness of that particular area of the body, with the awareness of this calm that's pervading us, and the awareness of our imagining the new world that we are building right now. Breathe.
Scattering all over. read your vision book.
Expand the head and exhale.
Expand through the head
and exhale. Expand through the head again and exhale. Bring your palms to the center. Center your dreams, center your imagination, center the rest of the world, center that whole new vision of the world that we are creating. Press your palms firmly and strongly together. Feel the bones of your hands pressing together, the bones of your forearms supporting, the bones of your upper arms. Feel the shoulder blades back on your back. Feel the rib cage. Feel the rib cage expand backwards as you inhale. Feel your heart protected in front by your sternum and your hands. Expanding forward and back. Inhale, expand side to side. Inhale, expand up and down. Gather in your vision. Bring it right down your midline, forehead, nose, chin, sternum, pubic bone, right down between your feet. Inhale it in. And exhale, scattering out to the universe. Scatter your vision, spread your vision wide. Take this inspiration with you through the rest of the day. If you have enjoyed this, scatter that inspiration to your friends, send them the link, get them to sign up for the mailing list so they too can experience this every damn weekday, either live with us at 11:45 a.m. Eastern Standard, or in replay whenever the heck you're awake and got some spare time. Enjoy your anatomy. I will see you tomorrow. Tell all your friends if you've enjoyed this. And if you haven't enjoyed it, let me know what I could do better because I'm super curious. Enjoy your anatomy, my friends. I will see you tomorrow. Same bat time, same bat channel. And breathe.